Hey everyone, my name is Dr. Jeff Pang. This particular video will teach you about tendinitis and tendinopathies. We'll first spend some time learning about what tendons are. We'll use images from a diagnostic ultrasound to help visualize what tendon pathology looks like. We'll talk about how critically important rehabilitation is to treat tendon disorders, and we'll discuss platelet-rich plasma injections, which can help promote recovery. So step one, what is a tendon? A tendon connects a muscle to a bone. When a muscle contracts, it generates a large amount of force, and this force is transferred through a tendon. The tendon then pulls on a bone, and this is how we get movement. Now, tendons are made from a bunch of protein, tightly packed together, and this is called collagen. And collagen fibers are what give tendons their strength. But even the strongest tendons have a maximum load that they can carry. And loads greater than this maximum amount will result in damage to that tendon. This can cause tendon inflammation, and if severe, can result in a tendon tear. We call this type of injury tendinitis, and tendinitis describes tendon injuries that result in or result from inflammation. Now, these usually are from acute injuries. Example includes sports or lifting heavy objects or being involved in some kind of trauma. But what about the people who have pain but don't have a specific injury? These people usually complain of a gradual worsening of their pain that then becomes persistent. Almost always, these are due to some type of repetitive stress injury, chronic overuse injury, or chronic overloading injury. These are better termed tendinosis or tendinopathy. So what's the difference? What's the difference between tendinitis and tendinopathy? The tendons in tendinopathy are chronically damaged. Let's imagine I went to the gym and I started doing bicep curls. And every time I do a bicep curl, what I'm really doing is I'm causing these small micro tears to my muscles and my tendons. Now this sounds scary, but this is actually how things work. On my rest days, my body will repair these tears and build it back bigger and build it back stronger. And this is how we get bigger muscles. But in overuse injuries, our bodies don't actually have enough time to repair all of these micro tears. So they start to add up. And when they add up, these micro tears cause our tightly packed collagen fibers to degenerate and to become disorganized. And when that happens, our tendons lose their strength. This leads to abnormal movements, it leads to joint dysfunction, and it ultimately leads to pain. And so we call the degenerated and disorganized tendon tendinosis or tendinopathy. And we can actually see all of this on a diagnostic ultrasound evaluation. The Achilles tendon is highlighted in green. Each long white line that you see running across the screen is a healthy fiber. Contrast that with this image of Achilles tendinopathy. The orange arrow shows just how thick this tendon is. The blue arrow shows the part of this tendon which is still normal. The red arrow shows the areas of the tendon with tendinosis. The fibers here are much more gray and even black in color. These areas are the degenerated and disorganized fibers, and this is why people are in so much pain. So the goal of treatment is to try to remodel these degenerated and disorganized fibers back into a state where they are tightly packed together. And this is where a structured and progressive rehabilitation program comes in. We start first with stretching exercises. Stretching helps regain range of motion and mobility, which can be affected when you're in pain. Stretching also puts gentle load on the tendon, which helps start the remodeling process. Try to aim to stretch 2 to 3 times a day during your rehabilitation program. And once your pain begins to improve, we want to then progressively load the tendon. First, start with low resistance exercises and eventually towards increasing that resistance. This progression of resistance helps load the tendon in such a way that the tendon fibers remodel back into its normal position. Try to do the resistance exercises once a day during your rehabilitation program. Now, a home rehabilitation program will help the majority of people dealing with tendon pain. But what about the people who have persistent or even worsening pain? And that's where injections come in. Now, historically, we gave cortisone injections to treat those with chronic overuse and repetitive stress injuries. And we are very quickly learning that cortisone injections may actually be the wrong thing to do. Many studies are actually coming out showing the toxicities of cortisone injections. Steroids actually restrict the delivery of nutrients to injured tissue. They slow down the formation of new tissue. They actually increase tissue degradation and they damage collagen. Fortunately, a significantly better option now exists, platelet-rich plasma. These injections use your own body's platelets to help treat the underlying tendinopathy. Our platelets control an incredible amount of growth factors. These growth factors are responsible for tissue healing, tissue remodeling, tissue proliferation, and most importantly, in controlling pain. So what we're doing with platelet-rich plasma injections is using your own body's capacity to control pain and to promote recovery, concentrating it, and then injecting it back into an area that's been irritated. And when we look at the studies comparing cortisone injections to platelet-rich plasma injections for the treatment of tendinopathies, it's not even close. The people who got platelet-rich plasma injections do far, far better. The most important thing to take away from this video is that most tendon problems are actually chronic overuse conditions. They usually occur in the absence of trauma and are more aptly named tendinopathy rather than tendinitis. And because it is a degenerative condition, a structured rehabilitation program can help progressively load the tendon to aid in healing. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this information useful, please share with others who you think may also benefit. Please also share your thoughts in the comments below and let me know if you have any ideas for future content. Please also consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. I can also be found on Twitter at JeffreyPengMD and I write on my blog at jeffreypengmd.com.